Our political reporter Ntakwane, thanks for joining me again. Now, earlier before, the intro of the package actually says the family is going back to start preparing for the events leading up to the funeral. What exactly are those events that can be expected?
Well, from what we understand, he will spend the night at home. There will be a day when he'll be lying in state. We don't know whether it's tomorrow or Monday, because initially it was said that the funeral would be on Monday, but now we understand that the funeral is on Tuesday. So it means that there's going to be a memorial service tomorrow and maybe something else on Monday, but the actual funeral will be in his home village, which is called Buhera, that is on Tuesday. So these are just some of the activities. Of course, it is a state-assisted funeral, and the MDCT had said it wanted the government to declare him a national hero, but the Prime Minister, or rather the President, has not yet pronounced, except to say that he will give him a fitting farewell, I suppose, because he is a former Prime Minister, but also because, as he says, of his role in democracy in Zimbabwe.
It's actually interesting that they say it's a state-assisted funeral. Do you think there were some maybe tensions around giving him an actual official state funeral?
Well, at this point, we don't know. But remember, when we spoke earlier, we spoke about how President Emmerson Mnangagwa went and visited Mr. Tswangarai when he was ill at his home. And he repeatedly said that he was looking to get unity back in Zimbabwe. But also, I think even more important, Tabile, is to hear him when he talks about how he wants to honor the legacy of Mr. Tswangarai by, one, ensuring that these upcoming elections that are going to be in a matter of months have to be free, fair, credible, and non-violent, as he would have wanted. But secondly, he says that he wants to hold a consultative meeting with political parties that are going to contest the elections to ensure that they are, as he says, free, fair, credible, and non-violent.
I think before we focus on those upcoming elections, let's look at Zimbabwean nationals in other countries. Can we expect, maybe specifically even in South Africa, a memorial service that will be held?
Well, here in South Africa, we saw today a service that was held by the Methodist Church, where his mother even spoke. And I think we can expect some of his supporters, I saw them wearing T-shirts today. I think we can expect to see some activities around that. But also, I think we can expect a lot of people probably to go to Zimbabwe to attend that funeral. When you listen to the niece, who is the spokesperson of the family, she says people, I mean, from the day that he passed on, there were a lot of supporters that poured onto the streets outside the headquarters of MDCT, and we have heard now that people are already going to Buhera, where the funeral is going to be, and the family pleading for support to ensure that some of the people who apparently are even fainting because of the amount of people who are there, that there can be facilities like ablutions, chairs and tents and other things that are required. The family really making that plea for whoever can support, but particularly to the government. So we expect that there will be a lot of events that will be happening.
Well, Ntakwane, are you still with us as we await those live visuals coming out of Harare as Morgan Tswangarai's body arrives there a little later on in the bulletin? Now we move on to...